It's a full hour, so. So welcome again. We are here today to present our annual one-act play. The dramatic arts class has done an amazing job putting this all together. The dress rehearsal went well, and we're very excited. We think you're really going to like this show. It's very contemporary. I think it's funny. Please remember, this is live theater, so do be respectful of your classmates and cheer them on. And again, I just can't say how proud I am of all the work that they put into this, and my crew and everybody. Everything really came together, and I think you're going to enjoy it. So sit back and enjoy.
Now this here, this is the floor. The floor keeps us from falling into the earth.
Oh, okay, good to know.
Now, you got your walls and your ceiling here. But I'm in charge of those. Any questions, just come to me.
No.
Any questions?
No, I think I got it figured out.
Good. Now, the Burgatorium team likes to do things a certain way. Before doing something, ask yourself this question. Will someone sue me? If the answer to that question is no, you can go ahead and do it. But if the answer to that question is yes, you do it. But very quietly. Mm-hmm. And then you sign your name to it, and come over here, and you sign this form, releasing the Burgatorium for any response for any injuries or illnesses.
Okay.
Now, you got your counters here. This is where the customers order their food and eat it over there, and then run to the bathrooms located on either sides of us. Behind us, the kitchen area. That's where all the magic happens. You're going to start in the kitchen area. But if you do good, you might just move to the counter. But the counter requires a whole different skill set, like pressing buttons and talking, but especially listening. Because if you look at the customer, they might just tell you what they want. And there's more button pressing and more talking. It's complicated. People go to school a long time to learn these skills. I think a short instructional video on the history of the Burgatorium will help you understand these skills. I'm going to go to my office and play League of Legends and deaden my soul.
Okay. The year was 1988. The United States was barely 212 years old. It was a simpler time, a time when families still ate together at dinner, while secretly wishing they were somewhere else. A time without cell phones or the internet. A time of innocence. And a young man named Michael Jackson released an album named Bad, and everyone began to think he was just a little weird. The Cold War was over, and one man, J. Tyler Higginbotham, decided it was the perfect opportunity to start his very own fast food restaurant.
Hey, you. You want some food?
His first idea, the Sardine Emporium in raw fishery, was a failure.
You want some raw fish? Do you?
So he decided to copy some other restaurants and sell burgers. But not just any burgers. Burgers that tasted good, but were also really, really cheap to prepare.
You want a burger?
And so, Jay Tyler opened the first Burgatorium in his garage. His first employee, his mother.
I'm so glad we can spend time together, J. Tyler.
That's Mr. Higginbotham to you. I don't pay you for this chit-chat.
I'm not getting paid at all.
And if you want to keep that salary, you'll get back to work.
He was a kind man. A visionary.
I don't feel well.
This is the second time you've been sick this week. I'm getting a little tired of the excuses.
My heart hurts.
Yeah? Well, my head hurts from your constant whining.
I love you, son.
That's nice. I love burgers. Go make some.
Death. Jay Tyler used the inheritance money to renovate a funeral home, turning it into his very first fast food restaurant. And from there on, he continued to expand, opening restaurant after restaurant after restaurant, after restaurant after restaurant, until he had four. And then he died. Or so we think, but the body was never found, and to this day there are rumors that... Never mind.
I quit. That's right. I quit. Find some other idiot to do this work. You're not going to have me to push around anymore. And you're the worst of the bunch. I hope you die. I hope your head gets stuck in the fryer and you boil in your skin. I want all of you dead. I hope this whole place burned down. Can I pick up my last check, Friday?
I think we got a spot for you.
Who was that?
Oh, no. Some loser used to work here a couple of seconds ago. That's not important. What is important is me. My name is Steve. I'm also known as the Fry Master.
Why?
Because I'm the master of fries.
I guess that makes sense.
And this is Celia, my right-hand man.
I'm a woman.
You are what I say you are.
Whatever.
Whatever what?
Whatever. Fry Master.
That's better. And you're still here. What's your name again?
Ashley.
From now on, Ashley, you're going to be known as Brad. Understood, Brad?
But my name's Ashley.
Listen, Brad, there's something that you got to understand here. I ain't king here. This is my domain. What I say becomes law. And what I say is that your name is Brad. Now then. Here's your work area. It's small because you are of no importance. Your job is to dump fries into the grease.
I know what you're thinking. You're thinking I'm too pretty to be working at a fast food restaurant. It's hard to be around me because I'm so much more attractive than everyone. It leads to a lot of jealousy.
Yeah, actually,
I try to warn people, but it comes up anyways.
My name's Debbie.
Hi, do you know
I have a lot of deep-seated emotional issues, but on the surface, they seem normal.
Right.
You'll find out later. Do you want to be friends?
Okay, everyone, stop what you're doing and listen to me.
No.
I've been informed by my informant in the government that the health inspectors are coming for a surprise inspection today.
What? We're gonna have to switch all the meat then.
Right, that's obviously step one.
Wait, the meat here's not good. I had one of those burgers for lunch.
It's okay, she's new.
Oh, where do we keep the pills?
They're in a bag.
Shouldn't I be in the burger?
When you hear them say step into the light, stay away from it, okay?
Okay, we cannot deal with the untimely death of the new girl. After the meat switch, we institute Plan Alpha.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Where's he going?
Scabby going home.
Samantha, you hide the rats. Steve, you...
Excuse me?
Yes?
Have you noticed me?
Sure.
Have you noticed that I am very attractive?
Right. Ashley.
Brad.
Brad, you hide the rats.
Thank you.
Here you go.
Debbie, you flush the towels out of the tube slide. Take the new girl with you.
I thought I was supposed to hide the rats.
I can't be expected to remember everything I'm supposed to say.
All right, let's go.
Are we ready for the health inspectors?
Stick with me, kid, and don't trust anybody. $19 an hour isn't enough.
You're making $19 an hour?
It's a crime, isn't it?
I'm making $6.
Didn't you negotiate your contract?
You can do that?
Sure. You never take their first offer. Their first offer to me was nothing except keeping the change that I found on the floor.
Oh, I just kind of thought you took what they offered.
No. All right, go give me the can of Crisco. We have to grease the slides up so the kids will slide right out. He's disgruntled.
Okay. I've thought about the current situation here. I guess I haven't been exactly fulfilling my responsibilities, whatnot. But it's not time to play the blame game. It can't be that bad. As far as sanitation goes, we've really dropped the ball. I think a short instructional video on what to do in a crisis situation will help us. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the nice little video.
Why is everything around here a video?
That way, they don't have to talk to us. It makes their job easier.
Hello! Welcome to the exciting new career in the dead-end job line of fast food. Look around you. This is where you'll be spending the best part of the rest of your life. But first, let's talk about the government. The government doesn't like you. So that's why they take things from you, like taxes. So, instead of actual money, which can be lost or taxed, they're gonna give you these neat little payment coupons. Ooh! They can be redeemed for prizes at the prize counter, boys and girls. Look, if you get 2,000 of them, you can get this cool portable CD player straight from the 90s. And see, if you get only 5, you can have this cool little eraser in the shape of a Christmas tree. Perfect for that time of the season. Now then, as far as other things like pensions and health insurance, those things are for squares. Cool people live on the edge, in the now. You're healthy now, right? Sweet! We're in for extreme employment! Burger Dorms is not responsible for pre-existing conditions or conditions that may exist into the future.
Safety hazard!
What?! Did someone say safety hazard?! They better not have, or they could be fired! Or sued! But I believe I've talked long enough. It's about time for me to introduce a little friend of mine whose various marketing activities have appealed to people with limited intellect. Here it is, everyone! Squirmy, the musical tapeworm!
I'm Squirmy, the musical tapeworm, and I have a story to tell. When I go in your intestine, yes, I live in your intestine, things will turn out just swell. Well, not so much swell for you as swell for me. You see, I'm a parasite. Do you know what a parasite is, kids? That's right. A parasite's just like you and me, except that we live parasitically. Something that you eat for you ends up being something for the two of you. Hey, you know what gets me all a-wrinkling and a-giggling?
What's funny?
History.
Whoa, me too.
Gee, we have so much in common. Maybe I should crawl in your mouth and live in your belly. But seriously, kids, did you know that tapeworm eggs are once used as diet pills?
Yes, I did!
Because without the benefits of modern medicine, people were pretty stupid.
They sure were!
And tapeworms would live in people's stomachs and grow and grow and grow. And soon, people wouldn't get any food because the tapeworm would get it all.
Wow, how large would they grow?
Well, I'm about 6 feet tall, right?
If you say so.
I do! Now imagine me twice the size of that, and then twice the size of that again, and then twice the size of that. That's over 40 feet tall.
Wow, that's really tall!
It is, and I'd be imagined as a coiling snake around your intestine.
That's cute.
It is. And I'd be a wriggling in there, and a giggling in there, and siphoning off all the nutrients that are supposed to be going into you.
You're like my little friend on the inside.
I am, except not that little. And I look like an eel. But that's enough about that. I feel a song coming on.
Oh, can I sing too?
No. No, you have a terrible voice.
My mommy says I make angels cry.
She's right. Now, if you don't mind, I'm going to sing a song about food safety.
Can I do the rhythm section?
No. Here's a little song about food safety. I think it might change your life. Always wash your hands. I hope you learned something today, little girl.
Maybe. Is there going to be any standardized testing on it?
Nope.
Then no.
Well, then you'll probably contract a terrible disease and die young. See you later, kids.
Ding, fries it done, ding, fries it done, ding, fries it done, ding, fries it done. I gotta run, I gotta run, I gotta run, I gotta run. I work at Burger King making flamethrower whoppers. I wear paper hats. Would you like an apple pie with that? Would you like an apple pie with that? Ding, fries it done, ding, fries it done, ding, fries it done, ding, fries it done. I gotta run, I gotta run, I gotta run, I gotta run. Don't touch the fries in hot fat. It really hurts bad, and so do skin grafts. Would you like an apple pie with that? Would you like an apple pie with that? Wait for the bell. Can't hear the bell. Where is the bell? Wait for the bell. Ding, fries are done. Ding, fries are done.
Why someone so attractive is working here.
What?
It's just temporary for me.
Mommy, Mommy!
What, sweetie?
I want the kids' meal.
You just ate. We're here to get something for Mommy.
Tell Mommy you want the kids' meal.
No, you need kids' meal.
You guys are cute. What are your names?
Mind your business!
Do you have a side salad?
Does it look like we have a side salad?
I could put some lettuce views for our burgers in a bag for you.
I want the merchandising tie-in toys from the latest hit movie.
Those toys are just cheap plastic, dear.
I want the merchandising tie-in! I can't have a full movie experience without owning the toy!
You can buy the toy separately for $1.99.
We're not getting the toy.
I want to live with Daddy.
Just let Mommy order, sweetie.
I want to live with Daddy!
You live with Mommy, sweetie!
Tell Mommy how much you hate her!
Ew, Mom!
Maybe you can just take the toy.
I don't think so.
We're gonna hold our breath till we get what we want.
I'll take a number one meal with a large Coke and an apple pie. Do you still fry those?
Yes.
Good, I'll take one of those then.
Are you sure they're gonna be okay?
Oh, they'll just do that till they pass out.
Do you take credit cards? Just Visa and MasterCard.
Do you take Discover?
Nope. Are you sure they're healthy?
Sweetheart, I never told you this, but you had an older brother once, and he did the same thing you're doing now, and now he's dead.
Now remember, darling, in a battle of wills, I will always win. You understand me?
I will always win.
Now run along and play.
I love mothering.
Oh, tell me to clean up, does he? Nobody tells me to clean up. Oh, I'm gonna clean him up.
Yeah, whatever, Steve.
Oh, you don't believe me? You don't think I wouldn't do something?
What are you gonna do?
Oh, you wanna know what I'm gonna do?
Yeah, what are you gonna
do? You wanna know?
Are you gonna tell me?
I'm going to do something.
Uh-huh.
That's for sure. It's not going to be nice. It's not gonna require a thank you card when I'm done either. It's probably going to involve fry grease. Probably going to involve fry grease being dumped on someone's head so they get second-degree burns on their face. Then a couple of other things. Not entirely sure what yet, but it won't be legal.
I can't believe there were four kids stuck in there.
Yeah, it happens.
Where does this Crisco go?
Back underneath the counter.
Right. Come here. Listen up, Brad. Not everyone is willing to go along with Torgas Badger. Do you know what I'm saying?
Not really.
Oh! He thinks he's so great making the budgets and managing the schedules, but there are forces deep within the Purgatorium that are going to bring him down. And on that day, Brad, you're going to have to pick a side. Will you be with the forces of darkness or the forces of me?
Today's just my first day.
Join me, Brad! And together we shall rule this Purgatorium as fry cook and assistant fry cook.
I thought I was assistant fry cook.
Yeah, no,
Okay. Fry cook, assistant fry cook, and assistant to the assistant fry cook. Okay, are you with me or not?
Well, I was just trying to make
money. Oh, that's right. Bury your head in the sand. Try to act like war won't come to you. But mark my words, Brad. War will come to you. War will come to you!
Hey, you want a soda or something? You get one free.
They're here. Everyone, you know what you're doing. Oh, not something. Anything. Friend?
Yes, I'm your friend, but you need to go back to your hole.
Hole's scary.
I know, just for a little bit.
Scabby's sad.
It's okay, back to your hole.
Scabby going home.
Eating establishment.
No.
Excuse me.
Welcome to Burgatorium, where we follow all guidelines distributed from the federal government. As you notice, my hands, they are clean and also lightly scented.
Could I just have a deluxe burger, please?
Of course. You should also know that all of our burgers are heated to 180 degrees and only use real beef. I mean cow. Beef cow. Without mad cow disease. Because we keep our cows healthy with things like grass, water, and food and stuff. And we keep our cows in the back, which is why we don't need to refrigerate them. Because you order something, and we just take a knife to it and cut it right off the cow. It's pretty much how you get your food. Would you like something to drink?
Can I have an iced tea, please?
We don't have iced tea.
And it says right there that you do.
The sign lies!
Okay.
How you got it on the sign, but don't sell it? What up with that? What kind of place are you running in?
A store in full compliance with federal health guidelines?
How about a Diet Pepsi?
Man, Diet Pepsi's for suckers.
Fine. I'll have one.
Word.
All right, enough of this charade. I shall now appear before you as I truly am. I'm Inspector Jenkins of the Department of Health.
And human services.
And this is my intern.
Straight up.
And we're here to inspect this restaurant.
Yeah, we're here to kick it to you, Department of Health and Human Services style, yo.
You can all come out now.
Come on out.
I quit. Y'all can take this job and shove it. I spent 5 years of my life here. What do I have to show for it? Nothing. Nothing. I hate you all.
Intern, make note of that.
Noted.
Now, we're going to take a quick tour of this facility, and for every violation that we discover, you will receive a demerit.
Demerit!
Okay, could you stop doing that?
Doing what?
Being like that.
Man, this is who I be. The man can't change me.
Okay, but so you know, you work for the government now. So you are officially part of the man.
You just blew my mind with that.
If you receive 10 demerits, the store will be closed down and you will all be fired. All right?
Got it.
Now, where is your manager? Do you have a manager?
I'm the manager.
What?
In the event the manager is unable to fulfill his or her duties, the counter girl with the most experience fill in as the manager. It's in our bylaws.
What bylaws?
Manager not present. One demerit.
Demerit!
Now let's take a look at the kitchen, shall we?
That won't be necessary. The kitchen is spotless.
Oh, it's hot up in here.
Everything looks to be in order here.
Thank you.
Wait a minute. What is that? Is that a fry on the floor?
These are not the fries you are looking for. Yeah.
Fry on the floor. To the merits.
To the merits.
Flies. To the merits.
Demerit! Demerit!
No hairnets. Two more demerits.
Demerit! And one.
You know, maybe a little conversation with Mr. Washington will change your mind.
What?
And maybe you could bring along his friend, Mr. Washington, again.
Are you trying to bribe me?
Now, I'm not saying I'm trying to bribe you. But if I were, would it work?
Bribery. One demerit.
Demerit!
Now let's take a look in the meat freezer, shall we?
What's cooler than being cool? Meat freezer.
Nice. Nice going, Steve.
Shut up.
You shut up.
Manager, dead in freezer. One demerit. Whoa.
What? I thought we were all fainting now.
This man was killed in the last hour. And all of you are suspects.
Dun, dun, dun. Well, I didn't do it.
Here is someone who not only had the motive, but the opportunity to kill Manager Torque. What?
How did he die anyway?
Oh, no, you didn't.
I asked the questions around here, got it?
But how do we know that he was murdered? Maybe he had a heart attack or something.
He probably just ate some of the food. I mean, the food is really good. It's to die for. Yeah.
Miss, I examined the body, and I discovered three things. One, that this was no accident. Two, that he was dead. Three, that he was murdered. Four, then one of you did it.
Oh! That helps!
But I already know who the murderer is!
Done! 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 What?
But I plan on keeping you all in suspense a little bit longer, because by the time I'm done, the real murderer would have confessed and we won't have to go through the boring business of a trial.
It was me! I did it!
Nah, just kidding.
And, as part of our health inspector training program, I shall now leave the first part of our investigation to my intern.
I don't know what to do.
First, look like you know everything.
Got it. Alright, all y'all going down, ain't nobody going nowhere.
Nice work, intern. Nice work.
First up, you!
Can't talk to me like that. I'm a person. I didn't do anything. I'm out of here. For good.
Boy, he's a good swimmer. Oh, wait!
Ah!
was mad at the manager.
He seemed normal to me.
Oh, wait! He's coming back! Oh, wait! No! Start again!
So then we get to you, the counter babe.
Thank you.
Where were you on the night of tonight?
Right here.
Oh, right here. Oh, you hear that? Right here.
But I didn't do it. First of all, I'm very attractive. And we all know murderers are ugly people with bad self-esteem issues based on oily skin and bad acne. They're also frequently fat. I work out 3 times a day and watch my fat intake very carefully. So I am guaranteed a fine life married to an older man with a 6-figure salary. And I've also picked out the color of my Hummer, which will be banana yellow.
Ah, you just got it all going on, huh? All planned out. But ain't it true, though, that you's a vegetarian? And in addition to being a vegetarian, isn't it true that you don't eat meat?
Vegetarian? Ain't that some type of a commie thing?
Yeah. Real Americans can't even spell vegetarian.
I cannot believe I'm working next to a vegetarian.
I thought you were my friend.
Okay. I'll come clean. I'm a vegetarian. What's so wrong with that?
Nothing. You're a commie.
Well, I rest my case. She be the killer. I will now recreate this scene in a flashback.
I do love flashbacks.
Check this out.
Silence mortal.
Oh, today looks like a Here's great how. Day to spread my message of peace, love, and kindness towards animals.
That's commie talk!
Quiet, Steve!
That's Frymaster to you. Oh.
Greetings, fellow employee. I enjoy hip-hop music.
I hug trees.
Have you heard Tupac's latest album? It really kicks.
Tupac died like 10 years ago.
That's what we just want you to believe.
I disagree with your musical preference. Therefore, I must kill you. Hi-ya! I'm gonna go eat a veggie burger now.
Case closed.
You eat veggie burgers? You know what they put in those?
Veggies?
Yeah, veggies. Veggies aren't cows.
You know Kung Fu?
That was actually a yoga move. But I didn't do it.
Nice try, intern. But I'm afraid the only thing that this commie is guilty of is bad taste, not murder.
Damn.
Because the real murderer is Celia. Did I say Celia? I meant Steve.
She did.
She's a zombie. Kill her.
Wait. No, I just fainted.
I don't believe you. We have to cut off her head. She's here to eat our brains.
Brains?
No, Scabby.
All right. Enough of this. This is my show, got it, everyone? And I was just about to make a wild accusation with no proof whatsoever, and then I'll get to the freaky guy.
Scabby loved brains.
Quiet, you. Now, Steve. Or should I call you by your real name? Steven.
You're Steven?
I haven't gone by that name since before you were born.
Well, I thought he was just a myth.
Oh, he's real. Rather, he was real.
I've been on you since the moment I walked in that door.
Oh, so you're gonna challenge the Frymaster.
You wanted to be manager, didn't you? You wanted to be manager so bad, you'd kill for it.
You know, you think you're pretty smart coming in here with your badges and your intern?
Straight up!
Oh, but there's one thing that you didn't take into account, my friend.
What's that?
My defense attorney. This is half of what I pay him for.
Dang.
Who are you?
I don't have to answer that question.
Well, how did you make it to the island?
Objection! Not germane to the case.
Man, that's some kind of vocab word. Germane?
Wasn't that one of the Jackson Five?
All right, Stephen.
Leading the witness.
Why can't I even say anything?
If you do not stop badgering my clients, I will be forced to countersue you into the fires of heck! To Kid Ridley, please.
All right, Stephen. Where were you when Torek was murdered?
That all depends on what when means.
Fine.
You know what? You're innocent. Whatever.
That brings us to the new girl.
That nobody likes.
Hey!
But it was you, wasn't it, Stephen?
My client doesn't have to answer that.
You shall not ask!
Fine.
You gotta admit, he got game.
Once again, our criminal justice system works perfectly to weed out those who cannot afford good lawyers.
This leaves us with three suspects. The universally hated Ashley.
What?
Sorry, kid. It's true.
That other girl behind the counter with the deep, dark, horrible secrets that nobody knows about.
Mm-hmm.
Or the weird hunchback in the corner. Scabby?
You leave Scabby alone.
Oh, Scabby ugly.
Well, finally somebody said it. It was about time.
No, Scabby, you just don't have a very good skin tone.
Scabby love you.
That's nice, Scabby. Quiet, we're friends.
Friends?
That's right, friends.
Friends eat brains?
No, Scabby, quiet.
Scabby going home.
Not so fast, Scabby.
Man, I think I finally got this.
What?
I know what's going on here. It's so obvious. This dude is this chick's daddy, and this dude robs the graves, takes the brains, and mashes them up and turns them into burgers, which is why they taste so dang good. And check this out. The manager finds out, he gets mad, he wants to ask Scabby, but instead, the chick kills him, and now they've taken his brains, mashed them up, and turned them into burgers. It's all so simple.
Man, that's messed up.
You're sick, you know that?
And I used to like you.
Wait, that's not what happened? Dang.
So, Scabby, if that is your real name, why don't you tell us where you were when Torek was murdered?
Scabby's scared.
It's okay, Scabby. I'm your friend.
No.
Tell me, Scabby.
Leave Scabby alone!
Tell me!
That's enough! Leave him alone. Can't you see that within that twisted hunchback extra lies an equally twisted hunchback heart? And can't you see that within that horribly twisted heart lies a soul? And in that soul is a man that I love?
Oh, Debbie! You gotta pick better boyfriends. I mean, if you're not judging somebody by their appearance, what have you really got to go on?
I don't care that he smells bad. I don't care that he doesn't even know my name. Look at him. I mean, look at him. He's really ugly.
Oh, no. Man, you bugging.
I am bugging. I'm bugging for this man. And no one can stop me.
Ooh, Debbie.
What's Scabby?
Scabby not attracted to you.
Damn! Oh! Cole.
Scabby just want to be friends.
What?
Sorry.
No!
If you'd like to sue for emotional distress, here's my card. Seriously, we can clean that guy up in court. Juries hate ugly people.
So if there are any other random surprises, that leaves...
Phew, some storm out there. Do I have the right place? Wanted, lovable cartoonish character to be mascot for low-end fast food restaurant. Previous experience is a plus. Is this the Burgatorium?
We're a little busy, lady.
Name's Birdie. You might have seen me on TV. Although I've been getting less and less airtime since that evil clown took over.
We're busy.
Did I mention I could fly? I mean, not very well. I kind of wobble a little bit. But sheesh, some place you got here. I mean, I used to be a star, you know? I used to be featured in all the Happy Meals. And then they got this thing that no one wanted to see a flying chicken anymore. And like, man,
he's a big shot, you know? With his big shoes and his face paint and that big purple fat thing. Is he supposed to be a sheik or something? I don't know. But you, let me tell you, you want drama?
Oh, we don't need no drama.
You go behind the scenes back there, and the Fry Guys are stabbing each other in the back, the Hamburglar's on probation, and that big purple fat thing, all he does is sit in the corner snorting sugar. It's a mess. I'm so glad to be out of there.
That's enough, Birdie. Time to go home.
Who are you?
We are the fairies. The fairies of copyright infringement.
What?
But you can't. She's public domain.
I'm afraid not. Birdie is a registered trademark of my client, whom I cannot name, but whom I refer to as the Arches.
We all know who that is.
Don't make me wave my wand of punitive lawsuits.
Oh, crap, be serious.
Mom, Birdie, I'm not your slave.
Oh, but we own you, Birdie. We own you.
I'm not going back.
Tough, get in the van. Wait.
No, please, help me!
Not my
problem.
Man, that's
what. Whatever you do, don't eat the nuggets! The nuggets are me! The nuggets are me!
Suddenly, I'm hungry.
Well, I guess that's that. I just don't know who the killer is. But, you know, there's one thing that's bothering me. It's probably nothing.
What's that?
Well, I'm sure it doesn't mean anything, but... Well, did you kill him, Ashley?
I didn't!
Oh, I'm sure you're right.
Aw, snap.
Shut it!
What? Why are you up in my grill? Don't you not be the intern?
Shut it.
Now you all street, huh? With your... Oh, so now you all street, huh? Don't you not be the intern? Whoa, I mean Health and Human Services, yo.
You better step back.
Oh, you think you crazy? Don't you not come from the suburbs? You don't know how wild we get up there. With our large houses, SUVs, and good school districts.
All right, that's enough. Look.
Hey, kids. It's me. Squirmy, the musical tapeworm. You see, I saw this ad in the newspaper. It said you need a brand new mascot. So what could be better than a cute tapeworm to love each and every tot? Because you see, this way, kids can eat and eat and eat. And they can supersize everything. But the only thing they'll be supersizing is the tiny parasite living in their stomachs.
That thing's gross.
You know what's really gross? You on the inside. I've been there.
Ew.
I laid eggs. No, don't throw up. You'll hurt my babies. This calls for a new song. It's called the birthing song. It goes a little...
All right, that's enough.
Don't you want to hear my song?
No, dude, you're disgusting.
Why does no one like me? You and Torek both.
You know Torek?
Well, I did.
Wait a minute.
But then I killed him.
Oh, you're the murderer?
Well, I like to think of it as more of a Zen thing. You see, there's really no life without death. Everything survives off the death of others. Like this restaurant.
That's commie talk!
It is.
Oh.
Sorry, Worm, but you're under arrest for the manager of Torek.
All right, wait.
What? He admitted it.
That may be, but our laws only apply to human beings. He is an invertebrate worm.
Does that mean I'm immune from the law?
Yeah, pretty much.
And I can kill anyone I want?
Yeah, almost.
Oh my god! You killed tables!
You monster!
Hey! You don't have to pay anymore!
Good boy.
Yeah.
That's two dead bodies. Demerit.
Demerit!
Which makes 10. So, store's closed and you're all fired.
Unemployed.
So I can kill anyone I want, right?
Well, wait.
Even health inspectors?
Oh! Sure.
Can I be the new mascot?
Absolutely.
You know what? Don't worry about the demerits. We're gonna go. Come on, intern.
I do have a name, you know.
All right, come on, Lil Peter.
Straight up. Let's get out of here.
Who says a gigantic parasitic worm is a problem?
I do.
You know what this makes me feel like? Singing. There's a place for me, a time and place for me, in your intestine, and your two kidneys deep in there, somewhere, somewhere. Hungry. Which one of you wants to eat some food?
Hey, Squirmy.
What?
Do you have a girlfriend?
I actually do, but she's probably really embarrassed to see me in this costume. Besides, I'm not attracted to you.
Oh.
Can we just be friends?
Sure.
Let's all be friends.
About meeting new faces, the smiles on your face, and you can.